traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning, your invested capital may be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford. And this video is not an investment advice. But today I don't do a trade with you, because today we are at weekend and here digital options are not available. So I'm going to discuss with you some other stuff, and this time I'm going to do some give you some information about how to trade for consistent profits or consistent returns. Yes, here, consistent profits. This means not profit, because profit can do everyone, yes, but consistent profits. And to gain consistent profits, you need more than only to play buy or sell. You need to understand a lot of concepts, yes, and one of the concepts is the concept of the practice account, and this video will be about this practice account trading, yes, and why it's so important. And you need, you see here, there are much more arrows, and I'm gonna do a lot of more videos about how to trade consistent profit, because there are many parts which have to be fulfilled, to which are required to get at the end consistent profits. Don't matter how much money, yes, I don't know talking about millions, I don't talk about to get rich, I talk about consistent profits. That can be everything. Important is only that you don't have to put money into the system, okay? So let's talk about the practice account, because time is flying by, and I try to make it short and good. So here we have the three types of traders which exist. In my opinion, I'm talking about my experience as trader, and every good pro trader has to pass by these three steps. Okay, these three steps: the newbie trader, the average trader, and at the end you are the pro trader. So let's talk about the newbie trader. Only on the balance you have on your demo account and your bet size on your demo account, I can classify you more or less to one of those categories of traders. The first, the newbie trader. The newbie trader has, I will do here some text box. The newbie trader has more than 100,000, more than $100,000 on his demo balance. Okay. The newbie trader, yes, this is number one. The newbie trader do bet size above $100 and more. Yes. So okay, this is a newbie trader, yes. Okay, and you can tell me in the comments if you can if you agree or not. Let me adjust the size of the text to make it a little bit smaller, so it don't steal so much space. So let me see, 9, okay, 9 is good. So this is the newbie trader, okay? Only on based on the balance and on your bet size, I would categorize you as newbie trader, yes? Okay, so let's see. What is with the and also wait, and there's not nothing something else. Plus, a newbie trader does on demo account a lot of trades, and trades on demo all the day. Okay, this is a newbie trader. It's not bad to be a newbie trader, because everyone was already a newbie trader, yes? Also me was a newbie trader, and I have done this also. So it's nothing bad about it, yes? This is how to classify a newbie trader. So let me talk about the average. The average trader, copy, paste. The average player has on his demo account less than 100,000. On the 100,000, yes, has less than 100,000 on his demo balance. So let me show 1,000 less than 1,000 on the demo balance. The bet size is above, is below 100, because he needs to prove himself that his win rate is good. Yes, so he don't need to bet as a lot, because else he had to restore always his deposits. So he's betting below 100. He does medium times of bets, not so much, that's not a lot, medium number of bets, and he trades on demo average a few hours, okay, not more, not less, only a few hours. So, and then we have the pro, then we have the pro. And the pro does this. So let me show you, because I need space below. So the pro has on his demo below card demo balance above 10,000. Yes, because you can reload, and he has below 10,000. His bet size is on the demo account, maybe $1, because he don't care about what he has on the demo account. The pro trader don't care about this, and he trades less than possible, less, because for the pro trader he trades only a few trades, yes, because he trades only trades when he needs to verify something, only this, because he knows already so much, and he trades only less number of trades, because he would else trade on, he is on the demo account mostly only to protect his real account, yes? And he trades a less number, only less number, yes, on less number, trades on demo account, and okay, trades on demo average. Okay, less number of times, or less time of on demo, only to, like I told you, only to avoid that his real account will be bet something accidentally. Yes. So this says are the three types of traders which exist. This is my opinion. This is my experience. I passed also through all these three steps. So if you agree, or if you are you disagree, you can write this in the comment. You can tell me also what kind of trader you are, and if you agree. So these are these three types of traders. So, and every type of, why it is important to have a practice account. The practice account is crucial, first of all, to get experience about the market and everything. Because if you don't have a practice account, you have to do this with real money. And with real money, it hurts a lot of more, yes, and you cannot do testing. The newbie trader does a lot of testing. He tested strategies, candlestick patterns, everything. He is testing, testing, and testing. He finds every 5 minutes and finds a new holy grail, to be sarcastic. And he is testing and testing. So to get from the newbie trader to the average trader, and from the average trader to the pro trader, there is some kind of circle. I call it the circle of death. Why? Obviously, it's not the death what is coming, yes, because you don't die. But with death, I mean you will quit learning and trading because of this circle. The circle works in this kind of manner. So let me do a circle here. Or maybe I do a rectangle. Yes, I do a rectangle. I do a rectangle. So this is this rectangle, yes. And it works in this manner. Circle, rectangle, it doesn't matter. Important is only that you understand how it works. So you are on your practice account, yes, till you are confident. So you get confident with a strategy, you get confident with some other stuff, yes, you get really confident, and you think you are really good, you are making good, you have a good win rate, and so on, and you think, okay, now it's time to go real, yes? So you go real, okay, wait. So you go real, yes. So and then there will be two possibilities. You go real and you get consistent profits, yes, and you are out. Let me draw a line here. Or let me draw an arrow. You get out to be a pro, yes, because you make consistent profits, yes, or you lose, yes, or you lose your real account deposit, yes, and goes and to go back to the practice account, yes, so easy, or you lose and you have lost so much that you go away. You stop trading, you quit, yes? You quit trading because you have lost a big amount or something and you are desperate and you go, you leave this this profession and says, okay, I don't want to lose any more money, I'm going to stop. So this circle, yes, here's this good. This will do this in this manner. So let me show you this. So this is consistent profits. This is consistent profits, and this here below. Let me draw this header. So this is quit. Stop trading. Quit. Quit trading. Okay, quit. So now we are talking about why you go back to the practice account. If you are a newbie and you got in this triangle of death, we call it the triangle of death, yes? And you put real money. It depends from your from the level, how much you put into, yes? How much you put into your real account, yes? What is this? Let me see. Okay. It depends from the amount of money, yes. Let me show you. So this, how motivated you will be to recover the money if you got back here. So it starts, yes, with a big amount, yes, the first time a big amount, copy, paste, then the amount you will put there in less, yes. After you have lost once, then it's going to be less and less and less till you pass all the steps here, yes, to be a pro trader. And these arrows here, yes, are always this this kind of pits, yes. I do a pit here, let me see, where you will fall into, yes, on your way. To be an average player, trader, yes. So let me see. You will show you this. So here are the pits. Yes, you are falling always into these pits. They are like traps. Yes, you fall into it. I do it. I make them black, so you see it better. You fall into it. Yes, and then it depends from you that you got out of them. So let me show you where to have some shape, right? Arrows, no shape. Here, you fall into this once, yes? And you have to climb out of them again. That means you have to invest again money, time, and everything to get out. And this will happen. And this will happen on every pit. So, okay, you fall into it. And out of it, you blow your account, and these steps are the same on this one here, yes? Let me see. So And why is so important the practice account and this circle here, this triangle? Because every time when you put money here into it, yes, let me explain this in this way. So money, yes, this is money, it's all money. First of all, a big amount, then you burn this big amount, and then you think, okay, next time I have to be more carefully because you lose some kind of confidence. Yes, you put less money, and then you put always less money. At the end, you are trying to understand why you have lost. And if you do this circle here a lot of times, you get here on always a step further. It's like you are playing some kind of role-playing game, some kind of World of Warcraft or something. You have to reach first the level 100. After you get the level 100, you try to get the best equipment. This is in the as metaphor. You try to get the best knowledge. Then you get try to get the best tools. Then you get always falling in some pit, you are losing a lot of money, you're going always on real. This is the other part of importance. This will be on the, another video when I'm going to talk about the real money account and the real money trades. Then I'm going to talk about the win rate, which is also crucial. Then I'm going to talk about the beliefs you have and so on. Yes, it's all the parts which are important here to get consistent profit. But I'm talking about the practice account. And this is some kind of information for you to make you motivating. Yes, I try to, because if you, because this money what you're going to lose here, yes, this is the motivator to stay into the game, into this trading, to be motivated because you want your money back. If this would, if you don't would put money into the system, yes, and you wouldn't not lose money, you would not motivated to do further. You would say, okay, why do I lose all the money? Yes, you would stop. And why you know that you could recover this money someday? Yes, when you are a pro trader, you are doing this movement here. This going on real. Understanding that you, your confidence was overconfident, that you doesn't understood everything, you go back to practice, then you practice again. And there I have to say, a lot of people, mostly the younger one, think that going on practice is some kind of time wasting. Yes, I had to hear so often, it's time wasting and why do you wasting your time? Practice account trading is not time wasting. You have to pass these three steps here to be a pro trader, because when you have to test some strategies, you have to test some candlestick patterns, you have to do this on the practice account, because on real account, you don't do a gold test. When you are on real, yes, as pro trader, you don't count, you cannot do testing and testing if this inverted bullish hammer will not work like you will work like you intend. Yes, this is what I want to try to explain you in this video, that as newbie trader, you have the right to test everything. You have the right to do testing, trading all the day. You are euphoric. After all these steps, you get to the average trader who is more who takes more care not about the size of the bets, he cares more about the win rate, yes, because the win rate is crucial, yes. And as pro trader, you have already done all your experience, you you know which patterns are working good, which setups are most profitable, and so you don't need to test anymore, yes. And so you don't care about how much the bet size. You try to do your bet only to see if this is a good setup or is it a bad setup. And this is how it goes, yes? And this is what, from my experience, what I have passed, and I can believe every one of you knows yet exactly at what point of as trader he is, if he is a newbie trader, an average trader, or a pro trader. And so you can distinguish yourself and see where you are. This step here is a crucial part, yes? Putting money into the system, failing, returning to practice, yes, and doing again, analyzing why I have failed, what I can do better, not to fail again, yes, because losing money, no one wants to lose money, yes, but the important part is that you go this circle a lot of time, this triangle a lot of time, to get at the end here consistent profits, yes? Because or you quit and then you lose, you stop and you have lost your money and you will be, you stop because you the profession is nothing for you. So this is the first part of multiple part of videos where I'm gonna explain you in theory what are the most important parts to get consistent profits. Yes, this is only one part. I hope I have motivated you to do practicing a lot. Yes, because you need practicing. It's a good possibility to learn the market movements, to learn how market works, and all this stuff. I hope. This video was informative to you, and I would like to know where you are. If you are a newbie trader, an average trader, a pro trader, not any of this, yes, is bad. Every stage is necessary to become a pro. Yes, you have to pass every stage of them. It is not so that you, when I say you are a newbie trader, it's not a bad sign. It's a good sign because as newbie trader, you have to do a lot of trades. You are a Forex. You think you will be millionaire. You will be rich. Yes, and you do back bet sides and you do low bet sides. You do trading every kind of setup. This is good. As average trader, you get more moderated. You already know something. You are not anymore so euphoric. You know that money can be lost easily, that the trading strategy or the skills you have are often working, but not always. And that is why you get sometimes a little bit frustrated. And as a pro trader, you are more than calm. You don't care about a loss. You don't care about demo account. You don't care about everything because you know you are confident. You know what you are doing. You have passed a lot of time on these two stages, so you have the confidence and the skills, the discipline, and everything because you have passed a lot of. You have lost a lot of money. You have made also money. Yes, it's not only that you lose money because you can make also money, but you didn't reach the goal or to consistent money because you yesterday someone has gone all week good. Yes, but at Friday he lost everything and he had to deposit more again and has lost all this. Also, this is also something. Yes, at the end, you have to pass these bad experiences to learn your lessons about how to trade for consistent profits and return. And these are things I can explain you this here with a nice image and with a slight nice slideshow with slight drawing. But at the end, you have to experience it by your own because no one can do it for you. And you know, like how it is. I can tell you everything, but if you don't do experience this on your own, you say, okay, it's like when I say, hey, you have to stop smoking because smoking is not good for your health. You say, yeah, yeah, okay, but you smoke anyway. So this is what I was trying to do in this video. This was the video about mindset, about how to trade for consistent profits or profits and return. And this was about the demo account, the first part. The next part will be maybe about win rate, about beliefs, about patience. Maybe I will do the discipline. A video because that are all such parts are really important yet and they influence a lot how you trade and how to become a pro trader. There are a lot of emotions into it also because every time if you lose money you get your confidence will decrease. You have to build up here in this fight, this because the fight up you have to build up your confidence always after you lose money and you return in this triangle. You have to build up your motivation. This is almost difficult, so it's not an easy way. Yes, it's a difficult way. You see, this is not done only for fun. This is a really hard stuff. So I think I talked about 25 minutes. It's enough. I hope you understood the concept behind this. I hope you recognize yourself at any stage of this ones here. And you can. And if you like this video, do a like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe. And if you have any questions, or if you agree or disagree, or if you have some idea about this concept, let me know about this in the comments. And stay safe, and bye bye.